Hello, my name is Susan Kraft, and this is Talk Art, a program funded by the Silicon Valley Open Studios. You can find out how to join Silicon Valley Open Studios by going to our website, svos.org. Today, we're going to talk with two art coaches who recently co-authored and published a fantastically informative DVD of their courses, and they are here with us in the studio today. Their names are Marco Zecchin and JD Savelli. You know, I've worked with both of you in a couple of different ways. You've come to SOLA to speak at two different years, not in a row, but two different years, and each time you came for several months in a row, and you packed the house, and people were busy taking notes and all of your literature, and it was very gracious of you to come and volunteer your time to our club. And then after the second year, I thought, this is perfect for me to hire you one-on-one for me, because I had created a new body of work, or I'd started, and it was very different for me. And I wasn't quite sure what to do. It was a political body of work, and I wasn't used to dealing with that. So you helped me focus my talk and my presence and my website and my PR focus as well. So can you describe to our studio audience and our TV audience, JD, what it, and by the way, did I mess up your name?
Savelli. JD Savelli, you did very good.
And I did say your name properly?
Very good.
Okay, good, good, good. All right. So the French and Italian, by the way, these men both come from Europe. One, Marco comes from Italy, and JD comes from France. And thank you very much for being here.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
Okay, so please tell everyone exactly, if you can, in like a minute or less, what you've done with the last 5 years of your life for art and artists with the marketing.
5 years ago, Susan, we created Marketing for Artists. And the objective of this education company is to help artists with the marketing of their art, to get them to sell their art and to be seen in public. And in order to do that, we have developed a program that helps the artists develop their voice, develop a clear understanding of who is their audience, who is their patron, and develop a plan which is fully adapted to who they are as an artist. So something which is ultimately very authentic. And that's what we have done.
Well, very good, very good. Now, and I certainly appreciate it, and so have many of the people in the audience here have heard you, I think, in our SOLA presentations. Now, Marco, I understand that you two have created a DVD of this fantastic course. Now, it's amazing to me that you've got all your information in a two-hour DVD, and I know that you want to reach, you're the artist of the two, right? Artist and marketing professional of both of you, and you have the personal goal to reach out to as many artists as possible to help unlock that ability to reach out, so we're not storing all of our great works in our studio and in our closets. And I'll tell you, I actually one time I rearranged a whole closet so I could pack my art in there. It's like, this is ridiculous, I'm storing my art in the closet. Okay, so I know that you don't want, as well as I do, to have artists storing work in their closet year after year and have the greatest collection of their own work. They need to get it out to people that can appreciate and have original art in their own homes. Now, how did you pack all this information to marketing art onto two DVDs?
It wasn't easy. We had to really work at distilling it down. Our courses are a day or 2 days in length, and there's a lot of information there. But we did. We finally figured out exactly the salient points that were important that that both JD and I discovered through those courses and through coaching, exactly what is important for each artist to really get a very defined story and understand their patron very clearly, and then getting a plan that really is something that they can live with and proceed forward with.
Well, like what happened with me.
Exactly.
I was able to proceed, I lived with it and I proceeded forward with it, and I cut you off. What else were you going to say?
No, we're just, we're trying with the DVD, we're trying to get it out to as many people as possible.
Yeah.
We've been here in the San Francisco Bay Area and Northern California offering our coursework, and it's really easy for people to come from this area and join us for our workshop. Outside of the area, we've had coaches. We have coached people outside of the area, in New York and in the South and in Texas and around. And they've asked us, you know, when are you coming out here to show, you know, to give your class,
yeah. Well,
and
they
we just
afford
haven't
it. I mean,
been able
you know,
to do
our,
that.
It's not the kind of thing. It's not like a corporate seminar where, you know, a big corporation can eat the cost of sending
exactly.
you. I mean, we're artists, and artists, you know, we're low budget people, but we need this just as much as a big corporation does, because, you know, in my opinion, art is the basis of humanity and civilization, and we artists don't really get the ability and don't have the backing, certainly, of especially in today's civilization in America anyway, we're not supported as well as we could have and have been in the past and other times.
So a DVD was a great way to do it.
It is
you
a
know,
great
ultimately,
way.
You reach a very large number of people,
yeah.
and very, very effectively.
Yeah.
And you know what helped us very much in putting the program into ours is we thought about the reaction of the audiences during these workshops, and we picked the points that made a lot of sense to them, those that they reacted
good.
Against. Yeah.
Yeah, great. Now, I do want to ask you, what problems do you see out there for the artists, and what do you see? Do you see any, what common problems do artists have?
Well, first, actually speaking about themselves and their artwork.
Mm-hmm.
That's probably the most difficult thing for most artists to do. The elevator speech, if you will, is...
The 20-second elevator speech?
Yes, the opportunity of being able to speak about their artwork cogently. JD and I really enjoy being around artists, and when we ask them, well, what kind of art do you do? I can't tell you that. Yeah, they stumble, they're glassy-eyed, and we're more than happy to help them and coach them through that while we're having a conversation.
Mm-hmm.
But we'd really like to have them be able to do that just completely on the fly and be very comfortable with that. And that's what we're trying to accomplish at the initial part.
And that's one of the key problems, is taking this ownership and running with their story. The other one is really identifying who do they sell to? Who are the people most likely to resonate with their art? At times, there are a lack of understanding of who are the right people, or a very narrow view of, oh, I need to find a gallery that's going to take care of my art. But there are so many other avenues in order to go out there and to be seen and to be sold that we help them just identify which are the right paths.
Now you have 10 top tips, and I think that we're going to... bring up 10 top tips, and I will read them for you. Here we are. So number one, keep the end in mind. Number two, one day at a time. Number three, set actionable goals. Number four, accept your limitations. Number five, get the skills you need. And number six, enroll a team. Oh, I see, engage and enroll a team. Number seven, just say no. Number eight, share your dream. Number nine, block time. And number 10, the most important, relax and have fun. So now I'd like to thank you very much for that, everybody. Yes, thank you. So what I'd like you to do is to explain each one of those in detail. We've got both of you. Can you start, JD? Can you start with number one? We've got number one. Number one is keep the end in mind. JD.
Very important to have a vision, a very clear objective of where you want to go. What is your ideal life as an artist? Where do you see yourself in 10 years? Because this vision is going to help you develop the right plan and going to help you when things are taking their time to happen.
Okay. And we're going to have number two. Number two is one day at a time. Marco?
Marketing is a marathon. This is not a 100-yard dash. You need to set your marketing goals and activities down and then go at them one at a time. Take your time with them. Get through it one at a time.
Can I have
and
a list of this?
One day at a time as well.
Oh, here, number three. Number three is coming up. Number three, set actionable goals.
It's great to have a vision. It's great to have a dream. Now we take the dream and we transform it into actions that ultimately bring results. Very important step in getting results.
All right. So now we've got number four coming up. Number four. Number four is accept your limitations.
You know, it's really important to know what you're good at and what you're not good at. So when it comes time to say, okay, am I really interested in going to that fair this weekend, and you hate to go to art fairs, you won't do that. It's something that you have to really be honest with yourself and appreciate about yourself.
I can hear that one, all right. Number five is get the skills you need.
You know, with artists, they are so gifted, they can almost do anything. But
yeah.
There are some areas where, well, it's lacking. Great opportunity to get the books, get the workshops, the seminars, and the like in order to acquire those skills that are going to be helpful with the marketing part.
You know, I go to a lot of seminars and I go to a lot of different events. So it's hard. You know, sometimes I have to force myself to do it, but it's great. Once you go there, you meet the people and you see things and you see other art and you see other artists and you see curators and jurors and you know, it's just,
like acquiring
it's really
the technique.
Important.
It's the same thing as acquiring the technique.
Number six is coming up here. Number six is rolling over us. Enroll a team.
That's right. You have friends and family and people that you know. Enroll them. Get them involved with what you're doing.
Okay.
Share with them your marketing goals and what you're trying to do, because they'll be helping you all the way along here and making it a lot easier to do.
Okay, so it's the people that help raise you up.
Exactly.
Okay. Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, you need that. Okay, and number seven? Just say no. No?
A great tip in time management. Learning to say no to the activities or to the suggestions that are not going to move you forward towards your actionable goals.
Okay, so give me an example.
Well, if you are a well-intentioned friend of mine, you're coming to see me, and you say, well, I've seen this great gallery, JD, in my neighborhood that you should send an application for. After a brief discussion together, I realize it's not the right gallery for me. I'm going to say, you know, Susan, thank you very much for helping me. I think you understand my dream, but I don't think I'm going to go for this gallery because my patrons are people who meet on a regular basis at a pet show close by. So if you hear of a pet show, come back to me.
Okay. All right.
I said no.
Well, very good.
I've enrolled your help.
Well, thank you for that example. I think examples are really helpful. So number eight. Eight is share your dream. And that's kind of what you just talked about, too. Share your dream, which goes along with just say no.
That's
so share your dream. What can you talk about that?
You just have to share your dreams. You have dreams, and if they stay inside of you, if we stay asleep and we don't share the dream, we can't make them come into reality. Mm-hmm. As long as we're dreaming in our heads, they'll never come out. So sharing your dreams with your friends, with your family members, you know, in the same group, that team that we're trying to engage, will help them, give them direction to help you and energize them to advocate for you as the artist to anybody and everybody that they meet.
Well, you know, I think that sharing your dream, not only does it help your team come up to speed with what you're doing, but it also helps you understand yourself because you hear yourself. And sometimes it takes a little while to tell your story a couple times and you really focus down and you hone it because people will react one way or another to it. And that's exactly what's been happening with this new body of work I was mentioning earlier, that people reacting one way or the other. And I have to ask myself those questions. Is that something I want to deal with, or is that something I want to just say, I've got an answer to this? So I think that sharing your dream is very important. And I like the succinct way of saying that. And I think I want to have that one written and put on my, you know, on top of my easel. Share your dream. And don't be shy about it.
No, don't be shy about it at all.
I mean, here it is. You're putting it out in visual form anyway, so why not have it in a verbal form? Because visual is much stronger than just a phrase here and there with people, because it's visual sticks much longer. Oh, we're up to number nine. Number nine is block time. Okay,
another
JD.
Tip.
Block
another
time.
Great tip on time management. Marco and I, we want something done for our business. What we make sure is we dedicate half an hour a day, first thing in the morning, for this particular activity. And if you dedicate half an hour a day every morning for months in hand, ultimately at the end of a year, you're going to have 180 hours of work done towards reaching that particular goal. Block time, very efficient way to get results.
Very good. You know, I say, no computers afternoon. If I'm not working in a computer project, you know, I'm getting paid as a consultant, but you know, that's my other job. But when I'm not working as a consultant and I'm just doing my art life, I make sure I'm not on the computer, no email, no nothing, no letters, no nothing, no web browsing, nothing past noon, because otherwise it'll be, if I keep going on, it's all of a sudden 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock, and all of a sudden part of my day has been eaten up, and that could have been 3 hours I would have spent in my studio figuring out what my next project is. You know, stretching the canvas. Oh, we're up to number 10. Okay, number 10. Relax.
And we relax. We enjoy doing our own art as we're breathing. That's the other part of it, is to breathe and relax. Take those deep breaths and allow that creative juice to flow.
Okay.
We do that in the studios. And now here we have, here, what JD and I have tried to do is develop a coursework that will provide you with the tools, the marketing tools, so that you can now create your own artful marketing plan, your own artful way of introducing and bringing your artwork out into the public that is really succinct and is really authentic to you and how you feel most comfortable presenting
your
work.
Very good.
That's why we call our DVD Creativity in Action. Ultimately, what you do is use all those artistic and creative skills, put them into action, but not with your paint and brush, but with marketing tools. Same creativity, different activity.
Okay. Very good. I somehow skipped that creativity in action. I would have said it a little earlier. So, is there anything else you want to say about your top 10 tips? They're great, by the way. I want to say that. I just want to say that they're great.
That's a great way to get started.
You know, there's a lot of nodding going on in the audience. So yes. You don't have to write these down. They're out in the lobby. You can pick them up on the way out. So,
most of them are commonsensical. They're applied. I mean, this is how we figured it out, because JD brought these from the marketing world and into the art world. Mm-hmm. These were so easily applicable and just needed a few little phrases changed in order for the artist, or for me as an artist, to not feel pulled back from doing the marketing myself.
Speaking of, you had to learn, this is one of the things that happened early on in your friendship. So you were friends brought together by common friends and said, hey, I've got a European friend over here. You guys might want to talk. So you're brought together by some odd, Europe is going to be the connection point, but it turned out to be a much deeper and stronger connection point, just that you both were from Europe, right? So, but when you did get together and started talking, you couldn't get any deeper than Europe, because you were trying to talk about what you do,
right?
And you were talking about what you do, and the language wasn't communicating properly at a very superficial level. So
we realized that the marketing language and the artistic language are different, and to a certain extent there are misconceptions, preconceptions on both sides, mm-hmm. that were creating a lot of potential friction, you know. Mm-hmm. There was notion of polluting art, there is notion of using terminology in marketing that was completely incomprehensible in the art world. And we started to communicate and figure out that after a while, there was a way to get to understand each other.
Now, what's an example? I think you were telling me earlier that one of the misconceptions that artists have is that marketing is a kind of like a bastardization or it's some sort of a, it's not a clean way to present your art. Like, it has to be like, you like my art because you love it because you know it, and that's not really a useful thought for an artist to actually engage someone in the public who might really want to have this in their home or have a collection of it,
There is this preconception that marketing is being a spin doctor. Mm-hmm. It's taking something and giving it, you know, a nice flavor and perfume. Real marketing, which is sustainable in the long term in establishing a brand or establishing an artist, is about being very authentic and clearly communicating this authenticity to the audience. And if you are consistent in doing that and you're very true to yourself, ultimately your brand and your artistic approach is going to stick, and that's what you're trying to do.
Oh, and I absolutely believe, if you think about any sort of brand that has lasted more than 10 or 5 years, you know, look at Kellogg's, right? Or if you look at Coco Chanel, right? Those brands and those people and those products came from a very, very deep love or interest in the product that they eventually delivered to the world, and it's because they were so big. They had such a great idea, and they were so true and dedicated to their idea that it's authentic.
It's authentic.
And it lasts. Authentic things last.
Completely true.
You know, and even in the art world, you have the same sort of thing going on. For example, if you look like a Dolly, the mustache, Andy Warhol with the bangs and the white hair, those are actually brands, which I had to learn from JD. That's one of the terms that was kind of difficult for me as an artist to get a hold on. Because you think of a brand, you think of Campbell's Soup. You don't think of me being branded as an artist. To get my message out, make it concise, make it clear, make it clean, and make it authentic is really that's all that we're really trying to do, and so that the artist can actually own that concept for themselves. They're the best salesperson for themselves. They're the best salesperson. So to get them comfortable to do that, that's the key.
And if you want to get philosophical about it, life is about being able to recognize someone or something and have a nutshell idea about it, because the world is too complicated. There's too many things that come at you all the time. You need to be able to recognize something quickly and distinctly, because otherwise you're just going to pass it over as a leaf falling from a tree. You know, there's a lot of those. But what's special about it, and what makes you connect to that one particular item in the world of all this? Especially even now, it's more and more. There's more fast-moving topics and people and things that you really do need to be able to stand out and let people grab onto that concept and idea without being false about it.
Right.
Right. It's the truth stands out. That's a little bit paradoxical in the marketing world, but the truth stand out. And the artists are amazingly bringing this truth out with their art. We're just helping them to put words and themselves into this truthful picture.
And you know, if you aren't truthful about it, you run out of energy. You can't run on false energy for very long. But if it's a real thing, it's coming from your deep within. That lasts forever. So you won't burn yourself out. You're just gonna. It's a wellspring of eternity. You know, as long as you have the physical ability to create and continue on with what you're doing, you'll be able to keep marketing yourself. You know, and marketing is just, it's the name that you have to put on something that happens.
Right.
You
know, it's really just being comfortable with yourself.
Right.
Really, holding on to what it is that you are so tightly, but gently, that you can present it at any time, and you know it. And you feel very comfortable in putting it out there.
I think the baby boomers, which we're all part of, have a real problem with marketing. And I blame it on Samantha Stevens and Darren. I really do. I really do. You know, I mean, because we saw Darren Stevens. He was an ad executive. And we saw what kind of bullshit went on there. Excuse me, can I say bullshit on TV? I'm sorry. No, it's cable. I can say bullshit. And we saw that, you know. I mean, we turned our nose up at this. Like, well, that is the fake part, right?
Right.
The witch part was true. You know, the advertising part was fake. So we all believe in witchcraft, but we don't believe in advertising anymore. And the New Agers, the baby boomers, are like that. You know, so that's kind of inside out. But I'm off the point. So, where were we? Okay.
Actually, you're not that far off the point. It is a magical experience once you gain yourself, once you become whole and authentic in your presentation of your artwork. There's nothing more magical, because things start happening. People start appearing, events start occurring, shows start happening just out of the blue, and that is the excitement. That's the exciting part that we have.
And for any artist, there is an audience out there which is waiting for this artist to present its art. So that's the good news. There is an audience out there for every single artist.
Yeah, because you can't be a sole entity in the world. I mean, as much as we want to think we're individuals, there are other people that are like-minded, right? Because otherwise no one would get married. No one would have friends. Nobody could join a club, right? So you know there's people out there that share your vision, and they don't have the ability or desire to create themselves, and you have the talent. So, okay, so we wax and wane. This is beautiful. I think I just have my floor director here is telling me that time has been marching on, if you can believe it or not. Time is marching on. And I do want to talk to you about, Marco and GD both, about you've got seminars that you give free seminars, and you give seminars that, actually what I need to do is talk about the free seminars and your one-day workshops and your one-on-one coachings, and how the galleries have hired you, and groups of friends get together and hire you. And maybe we don't want to talk about hiring so much, but I do want to talk about how you reach out into the community. So let's just go there. How you reach out into the community, and how that, we're going to go back to prior to the DVD, because you're going to continue on. You're not going to retire yourselves from reaching. Speaking of friends and knowing people that want to know what you know, and marketing yourselves, you're going to be marketing yourselves. So tell me some experiences about, tell me about Sola. How was it working at Sola? I mean, not working, but how was it delivering your speech to Sola and your lecture to Sola?
It was
Sola?
Delightful. We, you know, having the opportunity to stand in front of a room full of artists who are energetic individuals and maybe a little shy at times.
I do want to say this was at Pacific Art League, which is in Palo Alto, and they were kind enough to donate their room to Sola, and then you were kind enough to donate your talents and your marketing ability to Sola as well. So we were doubly blessed when you guys came. So go ahead.
Thank you.
Sorry for interrupting, but I just had to say it.
It's a delight. It's a delight in whatever venue, whenever we meet artists. It's always a delight to be able to talk to them, to hear what they've accomplished in their artwork, and then meshing their personal stories with their artwork is just an incredible opportunity to become even more intimate with somebody that you've just met. And the artwork is such an amazing open door that all we try to do is keep opening that door, widen it with that understanding of the individual that has actually made that artwork. And that's been always the exciting part of all of our courses that we've taught. That's why we won't stop teaching the courses.
Yeah, yes. One of the most striking moments in one of the seminars is at the end of the seminar, an older lady came to see me and said, "Thank you very much for running these seminars and teaching and talking about art the way you do and marketing your art. I'm 65 years old and I was planning to abandon painting."
Really?
You know, I was really planning to abandon painting, and after listening to you, I really find a new interest. And that was very very warming.
Yeah.
Very, very warming.
Because I know you've got a day job, right? I mean, you do marketing for corporations and things, so that just warms the cockles. Oops, I'm sorry, but the microphone warms the cockles of your heart. We're getting close to the end of our talk here for everybody. So, I do want to thank you both for coming very much, and I do also want to tell you that the Sola members have told me, the ones that have come to your seminars, that they really, really enjoyed getting together and talking and figuring out what their stories were and what their goals were and what their real stories were. So thank you very much again,
Susan,
for coming, JD
thank
and
you.
Marco,
thank you very
marketing much, Susan. For artists.org.